Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Being a Programmer. I am Rajashree and today we have to see Introduction to Python Programming. So without any further ado, let's quickly get started. In this video, we see what is the intro of your Python programming or what is the history, then why we use Python programming, what are the basic concepts in this language, and also we see the features of Python programming. So let's start the video. First of all, we see history of your Python programming. So first of all, Python is a popular programming language. And who was invented Python programming? So the name of father of your Python language is Guido van Rossum, and released in 1991. So in which process or when, what is the purpose of your Python programming language? So let's see. The use of Python programming is in web development, which is on server side, as well as software development, mathematics, system scripting, and many more sectors in which you can use your Python programming. So Python can be used on a server to create web application. Server based web application, if you want to create, then you then we use Python programming language. As well as it is a general purpose high level programming language and widely used among developers community, because it is widely used high level programming language. But why we use widely? So let's see. This Python was mainly developed on to improve your code readability, as well as syntax of your Python programming language allow programmers to express concept in fewer lines of code. That means it is a by using your Python programming, code readability is improved, also code reusability improved, as well as if you create a program of addition in Java which contains 10 line, then it is happen only in 2 or 3 lines in Python. That's why Python is useful or allow programmer to express your concept in less lines as compared to other language. I hope you understand the history and why we use Python language or where we use Python language. So next point is what can Python do? So first point is Python can be used on server to create web application. First use of Python to create web application. Server, if you want to create server based application, then you use Python programming language. Then next use is Python can be used to develop a software to create workflows. Then another use is Python can connect to database systems. It can also read and modify files. Database connectivity is easier as compared to other languages in Python, as well as if you want to read any file or modify that particular file, then you can use a Python. And then another use is Python can be used to handle big data and perform complex mathematics. We all know big data is trading in nowadays, and for that big data, your Python is helpful, as well as complex mathematics is solved by using a Python language. So solve complex mathematics and for big data, you can use Python, as well as it can be used for rapid prototyping or for a production ready software development. I hope you understand why we use Python language or use of your Python language. Then why Python? This is the in this concept you get the reason why we use Python. Because we have multiple languages, multiple programming language, but why Python? So let's see. Python works on different platforms such as Windows, Mac, Linux, Raspberry Pi, Unix. Multiple platforms are here on which you can use, or by using this platform or Python will be work. This is the first reason. Then another reason is Python has a simple syntax similar to English language. most important feature or most important reason, which is syntax. Because if any language provide a complex syntax, obviously we cannot go for it, because we need simple syntax which is English base or English similar to your English language and which is provided in your Python. Then another reason is Python has syntax that allows developers to write program with fewer lines than some other programming languages. Because our Python provide a developer a facility to write a program with fewer lines, which is not available feature in another programming language. That's why we use Python language. Then Python runs on an interpreter system, meaning that code can be executed as soon as it is written. This means that prototyping can be very quick. Python is a highly interpreted language or purely interpreted language. That's why our code are run on interpreted system. That's why prototyping is very quick, and this is the reason Python can be used higher. Then another reason is Python can be treated on procedural way, an object oriented way or functional way, because Python is a fully object oriented and interpreted language, and this is the reason, those are the reasons that's why we use Python. Then our next point is Python syntax compared to other programming language. Because we see syntax is most important in any programming language. So let's see what happened or what is the syntax as compared to other programming language of Python. So let's see. First point is Python was designed for readability. We see by using Python, readability is improved. And this is the reason to design Python language, to improve readability. And some similarities or syntax of your Python language is similar to English language, which is influenced from your mathematics, as well as Python uses new lines to complete a command as opposed to other programming languages, which is often some use semicolons or parentheses. So let's see, Python uses new line to complete a command, but other programming language, what happened in that? They use a semicolon or parenthesis. In Java language, if you describe our sentence is completed, then we have to use a semicolon. In some other languages, we have to use a parenthesis. But in Python, we simply use a new line or our cursor whenever we get on new line, which means our line is completed and we come to next line. There is no need to provide a semicolon as compared to your C and Java. Then another feature or another syntax difference or comparison is Python relies on indentation. What is meant by indentation? So let's see. Using white spaces, we define a scope, such as the scope of your loops, functions and classes. But in other programming languages, we have to use curly brackets for this purpose. Any other language you have to take as example, it is Java, it is your C language, or PHP, whatever. In those languages, we have to use curly brackets. If you want to provide a scope of your class, function, or any loop. If else loop, while loop, do while loop, any loop or function or class, if you want to describe the scope of that particular class, function, method, your loops, then you have to use a curly brackets. But in Python, there are indentation. What is meant by indentation? You simply use a white space to define a scope that particular loop, function or class. I hope you understand the differentiation in between different programming language syntax as compared to your Python. Then our last point in this tutorial is features of your Python language, because features are most important of any programming language, because why we use that particular programming language is depends on the features which provided by that particular language. So let's see, Python has many reasons because it is a popular and demanding language. And for that particular reason, Python has many reasons for its popularity, its demanding. And few reasons are mentioned here. That means few features are here. So first feature is it improves code readability. We see most important feature, code readability is here. Then as compared to other programming languages, in Python, there are shorter codes. Few lines of codes are here. If you develop a code of addition in your C language in between 8 to 10 lines, it is happen only in 2 to 3 lines in Python. Shorter codes are here and ease of writing is here. These three most important features which improves your Python as a popularity, as a demanding language. First feature is code reliability, second is shorter code, third is ease of writing, as well as programmer can express logical concept with fewer line of code as compared to languages such as C, C++, Java. Then another reason or another feature is support multiple programming paradigms. What is multiple programming paradigms? Such as object orientation, then imperative, functional programming, procedural. So your Java is fully object oriented language, but in case of Python, it is object oriented as well as it is imperative, functional programming language, as well as it is a procedural programming language. Then another feature is extensive support libraries. In your Python, or your Python provides extensive support libraries such as Django for web development, Pandas for data analytics, because we can develop data analytics, web development in your Python. And for that particular, you have to provide extensive support libraries. If you want to develop a web application, then you use Django, which is a framework of your Python. As well as if you want to work on data analytics, then you use Pandas libraries, which are provided by your Python. That's why extensive supportive libraries are here. This is the most important feature of your Python. Then last feature is dynamically typed language. What is mean by dynamically typed language? So let's see, data type is based on value assigning. Dynamic programming, because our Python is object oriented language, and we know object oriented language are dynamic, are also known as dynamic language. So these are the some features. So in this tutorial we see shorter history. Our Python is introduced in 1991, as well as we see the use of your Python language, or which are the sectors in which we use our Python. Then we see why we use Python, then comparison of syntax in between Python and other programming languages. Then we see some features of Python programming language, which are the reasons for being a popularity and demanding language, which is our Python. I hope this video is helpful for you. If you like the video, please do like to this video. Also, any suggestion, please let me know in the comment section. If you like my videos, subscribe to my channel for such new videos, as well as hit the bell icon for such new videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.